For the solid crochet granny square without the holes and without the seam, you will need, of course, crochet hook, yarn, and for stitch markers to mark the corners where you make increases. This square I will use for beautiful crochet booties. The link I will leave here. You will need only one big square and one smaller square for this. I use the ribbon yarn. You can use any yarn, also the t-shirt yarn will be perfect for this. We start with magic ring, adjustable ring, magic circle. They all have different names, but they all do the same. So for magic ring, this is my yarn tail. I wrap it around my two fingers this way. Grab my crochet hook, put the crochet hook through the first loop and grab the second strand and make a twist. And then from here comes our working yarn and we grab the working yarn and make a single crochet. Not a single crochet, make a slip stitch basically in this. So we secured our magic ring. And if you pull, you see it shrinks, but at the moment we will not pull. We will need it for our first row. Because this is chunky yarn, I will not do classic way immediately in the first loop, all the increases. I will start with 8 single crochet in the magic circle. Chain one. This will count as our first stitch. And 7 more. We can count. This is our 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If you will make too many stitches working with chunky yarn, you will not close this middle hole very closely, but I found this way it works very good. Now I make the slip stitch in this first chain we created. It might be a little bit tight, but do not worry. So we closed our magic ring. Now we can close the hole, and later we'll be able to close even smaller. Now, in order to get rid of the seam, which normally looks like this in a ready granny crochet square, you see, if we start in the middle of this straight part, then no matter how hard we try, we will end up with this seam. It's maybe not too bad, but it is visible. And in this, I did the increases only in the corners, so you can't really tell where was our row ending and beginning. Therefore, I will use half double crochet to make it more solid. That's why for half double crochet, I chain two. Yarn over, and in the same stitch, one more. So we will have on the corners 4 half double crochet. Stitch marker to mark the middle. This will be the place where we'll be increasing. And now, next stitch, there is 1 half double crochet and 4 in next one. Again, this will be our second corner. and we mark the middle in between, so 2 2. And the next will be our side and start with 1/2 double crochet and 4 for our corner number 3. And again, take stitch marker and we mark the middle. 1 and again 4. And our last stitch marker for corner number 4. And here is an increase, here is an increase, 1 stitch left for 1/2 double crochet. So all together in the second row we should have 20 stitches. And now we need to get into this middle by using 2 slip stitches. We just find these 2 chains from the beginning where we made, and I actually that is from the front, slip stitch. In the next loop where was our first increase stitch, and then slip stitch in the next. Take out the marker and make another slip stitch in the place where marker was. And now we start the next row from this corner. So again, chain 2 because we are making half double crochet, and 3 more in the same stitch. Later you might get rid of the stitch markers. It's just for the beginning so you don't get confused, because later you will be able to see exactly. So the increase will come on top of the increase. And now we have 4 stitches, 4 half double crochet until we get to our second corner. This will be our second corner, 4 half double crochet. Again, we can take our stitch marker, put it back in the middle. And now again, we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Until we get to the next corner. Four half double crochet in the same stitch. And now we continue until the end of the row, and I will show you when we get there. We are at the end of the round number 3. We made our corner is 4 half double crochets, 4 half double crochets in the next 4 stitches. And now we are ready to get here using the slip stitches. Find this second chain two. In the second chain we make a slip stitch. We make slip stitch also in the next stitch. And we come with the slip stitch to the place where we start again our 4 half double crochets for a corner increase. Again, chain 2 and 3 more half double crochet in the corner. And now, until we get to our next increase, we will need to put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 half double crochet. And this way, we work all the rows until we get to desired size. I will show you this part one more time when I get to the end. This is how it looks after 4 rows. We start to see the shaping. And it's absolutely solid and you can't see the seam almost. And again, to start the new row, we find those two chain two we did in the beginning. In the second, we make a slip stitch, make a slip stitch in the next. So basically we do 3 slip stitches until we get to the corner where you know we have to make another slip stitch just to get in the middle. And we make chain two again. And 3 more half double crochet. This is our new corner. So basically, if you don't take out the stitch markers, you can work as big as you want, just knowing that in these corners you will have 4 half double crochets and the next ones will be half double crochet in each stitch. When we think we are done, we don't do the last stitch, we don't do slip stitch. There is our last stitch. We pull, we cut the yarn, we pull out. And now we put the crochet hook in this stitch. Not in those chain two, but this next stitch from back to front. You can use smaller crochet hook size. And we push the thread on the back side. And now we will imitate this chain and we will now need to go back the last stitch we made. We grab our working yarn and pull through. And now we just secure our yarn tails and we have such a nice finishing. In the chunky yarn wool, of course, maybe if you look closer, you will see here, sort of slightly like a seam, but if you will work on a smaller thread yarn, you will not be able to see anything. But if you look closely, you will be able to see here. But it is much better option than leaving this visible row change in the middle of the sides. So please have a look at my crochet booties tutorial. It's very super simple, easy. You just need 2 crochet squares like this and just seaming them together. And I hope to see you next time. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.